Hi viewers, today we will discuss what are the basic questions that you should ask from the seller. Being a property agent, you will have the experience of these kinds of questions, but still I have some questions that could help you that you can ask from the seller. So the first question is how many beds? Means how many beds? It's villa, townhouse, apartment, building. So you should ask this first. Then a community. What is the community? Means it could be a specific community, gated community, like in Dubai this Amaranta, Villanova, Arabella, Arabian Ranches. So you should ask the community. A square feet. What are the square feet? What is the size of the concerned area of seller? Pictures and videos. Ask from him if you have available pictures and videos. Vacant or rented? It could be vacant, it could be rented. Means if it is rented, so it's a bit difficult for viewing, but if it is vacant, so it's very easy to sell it. Finance or cash? There are some properties that may be mortgage, so the owner will prefer finance, because if it is mortgage, so the owner will not be able to sell it out. So ask from him, seller, you are comfortable with both cash buyer and finance buyer, so you ask from him. When you are planning to sell it, it's very important question. Why? Because if he is not in rush, so he will waste your time. Or maybe sometime he will ask, only he is asking the market price. So ask from him when you are planning to sell it, okay? Viewing procedure. If the villa is vacant, so it's very easy. He will tell you anytime you can view the villa. But if the villa is rented, so you need to find a very serious buyer for them, for the villa. Because you cannot view the villa, the tenanted villa, very easily. You have to take the permission, and even the owner will take the permission from the tenant. Contact details. You should have the number, the calling number of the seller. Sometime he's the seller will be from Saudi Arabia, from any nationality, so you can his WhatsApp will be on different number, so you should have the proper contact number so that you can call him, and also the proper time. The proper time, you should know that sometime he must be having some proper time. You can call at that time, so you will be comfortable and the seller will also. Unit number you should ask, okay? Means what is the unit number, if it is a villa or apartment. Furnish or unfurnished. If it is furnished, so you can ask from him, you want to sell it as a furnished or you will keep the furniture with you, okay? You ask some specific questions, single row, back to back, corner unit, semi detached, standalone, apartment. So these are some questions that mostly that I said single row, so it's coming in villa, okay? But keep this in your mind, whenever the seller tell you that I have the villa in this community, you should have the information or collect information. So it will be very easy for you to understand, so you will not ask different questions from the seller. So the most important thing, you should have the information. So it will be very easy, to ask the very specific less questions from the buyer, because from the seller, because you have the information. So and asking price is very important. Why? Because if he is serious buyer, a seller, if he is serious seller, what he will do, he will tell you what is the market price, I will sell on that, because he is serious. If he is not serious, then he will tell you that I will sell it on that price, which will be not market price. If a seller is serious, he will sell it on market price, and he know the market price, he will know. If he didn't know, you tell him that this is the market price, so then you will know that how much he is serious, okay? giving the market price. It is very important to give the market price. Sometime he will not be in rush. He will not be in rush, so he will waste your time. So better to ask what is the asking price, okay? Exact villa location, you know, you should know the exact villa location. Unit number, if you know, you should know the exact villa location. And if you know, if you don't know that much the community, you should visit. You should visit that community, because you will have a better idea. Only then you will understand, and it will be easy for you to sell it out. Check there is balcony, terrace, total floors, garden area, means what developer, who is the developer, everything you should have the information. Okay, whenever you have that much of information, it means the seller is serious. Because keep in your mind, whenever the seller is serious, he will give you every single question answer. Every single question, because he is serious. Okay? If he is serious that much, then you try to exclusive. Being an agent, try to exclusive. Tell him that, sir, give this villa or apartment or anything exclusive to me. If anyone is contacting you, you can give me direct me my number. In this, you have two benefits. One benefit is that if somebody is calling you, so you will give my number. And the second is, I will make it, I will post it on every advertisement. So it will be very easy for you to sell it. Okay, you can give that much of information. So the most important thing, try this villa or apartment to take it exclusive from the owner. That's the main thing. And for exclusivity, you should have title deed, ID copy, and then send the form A for to the owner. He will sign it as an exclusive. Okay. Three things you should know. One is that you should have all the information from the seller. Okay, this is very important. You should have a very good communication with the seller. Only then it will be very easy for you to sell it out. Because sometime if he is not picking up the phone, you have a buyer, you have posted the ad, and you don't have you have buyer and you have everything, and if he is not picking up the phone, then it's a waste of time. So try, you should have all the information, you should have a very good relation with the seller. Okay. And at the last, I will tell you some bad experiences. First, you should ask from the seller that you are the owner or no. You should ask this question. Sometimes he will not be the owner. Sometimes he may be agent. Sometimes he may be POA. Okay? So you should have the confirmation of these things. You should ask, means very normal question. You should ask that you are the owner, sir, please. If he say yes, okay, then you can do all these questions and everything. Sometime he will be agent. Whenever you bring the buyer, then he will say, I have a 50% in that. Or if he is a POA, for example, POA, okay, then he will say that I have a 25% in that. Clear it, make it clear. So it will be very easy for you. Then you can work on it. And if you are not getting these questions, these are the questions you should know. If the seller is serious, he will give you the answer of every question. And these are the questions that seller will be happy to give you answer, because the seller know that if somebody want to buy my property, he will need all the information. So don't hesitate, ask this question. If somebody is not giving you answer of this question, there will be two things. Either he is not the owner, and the second thing, he is not serious. He just only want to know the market price, okay? And also, sometime he will be know the market price, and he will not give you every single question answer. So keep these things in your mind, that these are the questions which is very important. You should ask from the seller. And you should have the information of any specific community. Hope you like this video. I have many videos on my channel that can help you. I'm creating more videos. The next video will be of buyer, what you should ask from buyer, then landlord and tenant also, and all regarding property. I have many videos on my channel. Hope you like this video. Thank you so much. Take care.